To the next item, which is validation of the voters register.
Yeah.
Now, for the past 2 weeks, a lot of words have been bandied about validation, verification, authentication, and all that. Now, what is it exactly that the NPP wants to see once done when it comes to preparing a credible register for 2016 elections? I believe that is what has generated the contention over whether it's validation or verification or whatever. Okay. What is it exactly that the NPP wants to see?
Thank you. I think it's not only NPP. Mm. All political parties.
It's a lie.
All political parties have problem with the register. Mm. All of us. All of us, including NDC, have identified that there is a problem with the register. The register is bloated. We have names that are not supposed to be in the register and all that. Our stand is that let's throw this register away. Let's burn it. Then we get a new register. NDC.
EC says they are not able to do that.
NDC stand is that no, we don't need new register. We want audit. We want to audit the register.
Is that the same as cleaning?
That's what they claim. Oh,
okay.
And then EC quickly bought into the idea of NDC that we are not going for any new register, but we'll audit it. Fine. In the past, we heard the chairperson saying they've contracted some auditors to audit the register and all that, without the knowledge of IPAC, without the knowledge of the stakeholders in this game. We said, no, we cannot do that, you see. So let the political parties know what you are doing, who are the auditors, what are the criteria they are using to audit the whole thing. If they want to audit it, every political party should be represented so that there will be a fair play, you see. Now, the bone of contention now is whether we get new or we audit it. EC hardly brought out a timetable eliminating a new register.
Okay.
So it means that there's no way we are going to have a new register. Now, EC made us aware that he's, constituting a committee, and the committee should organize a forum and then collect views from the stakeholders. Mm.
Well, then that is a committee of expert persons.
That's right. The five,
that's
right.
Okay.
So he made us aware that whatever recommendation they'll bring, that's what the EC is going to work with. The commission finished the work, submitted a report. In the report, they stated clearly that what EC is proposing, that they will use exhibition to clean the register, is not viable. It's not workable. It's not enough. It cannot eliminate anything. So in page 20 to 21, they stated there clearly that they should do validation. Now, the validation means that every registered voter, when there is time for exhibition, you go there with your voter's ID card, and then any other national ID, you go there physically. Then they go through, they take your fingerprint, and then verify you that it is you. Then they take you. It means you are qualified, you are a voter. Now, by the close of the day, if I decide not to go, it means that I am a ghost, or I am not entitled to be in the register.
Okay.
Then my name will be expunged from the register. Then by the close of that exhibition, together with this validation, we'll have a credible register. In a way, it means that we've gotten a new register.
You would have been another way.
That's right.
Had a new register.
That's right. You see, and you say, no, they will not go by that. We say, then what is the essence of using our taxpayers' money to organize that forum? Look, the committee of experts, the five committee, we know they did not work for free. We paid them.
Mm.
And those people, when they sit 1 hour, you know the amount of dollars that we pay them, you know. So the forum, you rented the place, food, water, whatever.
Yeah.
How much
words, money? You know,
yes, that's right. So if EC decide to throw away that report, then they are not being fair to Ghanaians.
Okay.
They've wasted our money. And then we need to, sanction them.
Okay.
So we are saying that instead of maybe what they are saying as beating. Look, from 1992, anytime we write names for new, voters, we open the register for exhibition. You go there either to check whether your name is spelled correctly or whatever. If there is nothing, they just correct it. Nobody, under no circumstances, should anyone's name has been removed out of the exhibition of a register. But in this case, why we decide to do validation, the reason why they don't want to agree, these people, when I say these people, NDC.
Okay.
NDC, yeah. Okay. It is alleged. Mm. And in fact, it's a matter of fact that we know some of them. I know some Nigerians who are holding Ghana's voter ID card.
Okay.
Yes. So,
well, since you cannot substantiate that.
Oh, not that I cannot substantiate. If you prompt me tomorrow, I can take you to some places. When you go there, you start speaking, you know. Nobody will tell you that this one is a Nigerian.
Okay.
Are you getting it? But
yeah,
he's holding ID card.
Okay.
If that person comes to a polling station, that, look, I'm coming to validate, you need to prove your nationality.
Yeah.
Are you getting it?
Yeah.
It's not surprising that even the head, the chairperson of Electoral Commission, is not a full Ghanaian.
Oh.
But meanwhile, yes, it's true.
So, yeah,
look, this woman.
There's nothing when, I have
oh,
Ghanaian.
Please. This woman, when he was traveling to Canada to do his master's, he traveled on Nigerian passport.
Okay.
Which is a fact. We can go to immigration and then verify this.
Are
you getting it?
No. Okay, thank you very much. We'll just take that as an allegation.
The thing is, you can verify from immigration immediately.
Yeah.
Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
He's a Nigerian.
We are going to, you know, verify that. Yeah. Your take.
Thank you very much, William. I think we should get this thing
very.
We should get this thing very right. There is nothing like half Ghanaian or quarter Ghanaian. A Ghanaian is a Ghanaian.
Actually, we want to focus on the validation.
I will. You know, you go around town, you see Lebanese who are born here have the right to become Ghanaians. Nigerians might have similar conditions, but their language, the tonation of their language does not mean that they are. Now, coming back to the EC, the validation issue,
yes.
Let us get it clear again that EC is an independent body, equivalent to an appeal court. Not even the president can interfere in its work. That is why EC coordinates with stakeholders, which happens to be political parties and other non-governmental organizations that work within that electoral process.
Let's be a bit more focused.
We will.
What is the difficulty?
No,
if any, you have with this idea of
definitely. I'm trying to. You know, William. Hmm. I think 19. I'm trying to come out with a process.
Okay.
From 1994. '96 to '98, I was a member of IPAC. Understand? A full-fledged member of IPAC.
Okay.
On the ticket of the Eagle Party. You remember Eagle Party?
Yes.
I've known this process for a long time, and I know what it takes. It has not changed. When people talk about validation, what at all are we talking about? To validate what? The EC have come out. It's a roadmap that ending of this month to first week in May, there is going to be a limited registration, okay? And telling people who have clocked the age of 18 plus, when that is done, they are talking about exhibition. You understand?
First of all, there's going to be limited registration.
That's what I just said.
And then thereafter, exhibition,
exactly. So from there, you can go to find out whether before our names are in the register. Remember, the system we are using now was not the same when we started in 1992. It is never true when MPP keep on saying that any new initiative in terms of process in the electoral process this Saturday is not true. It is not true. You remember?
I don't remember him saying.
Not him. I said them. When they have the opportunity.
Okay. And it's true.
You see, they were taught. But you see, the reality is that your first general secretary may so rest in perfect peace. Ajemi Boateng. Uh-huh. We sit on table at uh-huh. IPAC.
Yeah.
When we used to have only in the capital, I think Accra and Kumasi, where we used to have ID on voter ID cards. You remember? It was the Ege party that stood up. Supported by Wobu, I think there was the name of his party now. I forgot. Exactly. We stood up. The record is there. That look, instead of sending us to conferences and seminars outside this country, let's appeal to donor agencies to fund each and everyone's picture on the voter ID. Listen to me. I am telling you, mentioning names.
Okay.
You see,
you finish.
You see, you were told you were not there. Huh? So I'm telling you, you were told you were not there. Okay. So I'm just telling you.
Let me just explain this.
Yeah.
We don't have all the time.
I agree. It's a very serious business transaction. I mean, it must be explained well. I agree with you. After the exhibition, okay, where there have been minors and pluses. Then comes the auditing. You understand? And get it clear. This biometric way of voting, okay, there is no way somebody can vote on behalf of anybody. Because you remember, even when I went to cast my vote, it took some time. I was rejected by the machine. You understand? But my picture was there. And the MPP agents in my constituency, Afaja Tosaf, insisted that they must hear the beef of the machine before, and to God be the glory, it occurred, and I cast my vote. So if you are telling me that you have to validate non-existing register, then I find it difficult to understand, because if they should do the validation before the limited registration, then it's like, let's assume, William, you travel from here to Paga, you work in Accra, but because you want to exercise your responsibility as a citizen, you travel from here to Paga to do your registration. Then you are back again. Within a short time, you are there again. It's not convenient for anybody to do so. So if you are talking about, and remember, there is nothing like validation in the report of the five prominent citizens. There is nothing like that.
Yeah, but he mentioned some page.
It is not true. I was trying to get a page for you. I have it here, but my battery is low. That I asked him to charge my phone for me. Okay. You see, it is not true.
Okay. So what did they say?
And
page 17.
Hold on. There's no time. No, there's no time. You had your time. No, you had the time. You had the time. They were the same people who poo-poo the five members when they formed that committee. They rubbished the committee. Pointing figures. Naming people, but at the end of the day, they are here talking about their recommendation. And to God be the glory, the chairman of the Peace Council, I've forgotten his name, Reverend Dr.
Emmanuel Asante.
Yeah, he said they did not recommend anything like that.
He did not read
No. You see,
he did not read that report.
You see,
he said that he does not remember.
No, he was not the chairman.
VC.
Yeah, so he's a member. He have a copy, and I'm sure he went through. He went through the whole book before presentation.
Let me ask you my final question on this one. Now, the NPP is saying that there's problem with the register, and this one we all agree to that there are names of minors, and by now, some people who have moved on into eternity also have their names there. So what they are saying is that let's use this opportunity for limited registration to also allow people who have their names there and who are interested in casting their vote to show up with their ID and say, take my name, put it in the record so that we use it for 2016. You have problem with that?
I don't have any. I think that is the exhibition we are talking about, isn't it?
So why are we going? Because
no, because they are talking about validation.
That's not his vision. That's not his vision.
No. What I'm saying is
no. What he's saying is not his vision.
It's not his vision.
What he's saying.
It's not his vision.
Hold it.
Open up the register.
Hold it. When we have the limited registration to take care of those who are 18 and those who don't have their names in there because they have traveled outside, but now they are interested in putting their names.
Exactly.
They are the people that we are going
the
to
The exercise
register.
Is meant for. Yeah. Exactly.
Thereafter, there will be exhibition where we come.
Yeah, you and I,
yes,
who already exist in the book.
And say that I'm interested in voting.
Yeah.
So here are my details.
Yeah.
Confirmed.
Yeah.
Not so.
Exactly.
Uh-huh. So do you have any problem with that?
We absolutely no problem with that. That is the process of even auditing. Because when that is done, that is where you and I will know the minus and the plus in that register. And when that is completed, that process is completed, we will come up with a new register. It will be completely new.
Okay.
It might even be that the population that we had earlier in 2012 might not be the same. It might also be that after that exercise, the number might go up. So all said
what
and done.
What about those who are not able to show up? Will they also be given opportunity to vote when they show up at the polling stations on November 7?
Yeah, but I think it would be fair for us as a citizen to participate in the process. You understand me? If you want to be governed by a quality leader like John Dramani Mahama, it is your responsibility to go and actually find out if your details.
Okay.
Up to date. Right. You see, a quick on one, Willa. No, Willa, a very quick one.
Let us get. I'd like to conclude. No. There's no difference between.
Exactly. Let's get this thing clear. You see, there is this body. I don't know how to call them. Let my vote count. They don't have to. I'm glad the EC is not even paying attention to them. If they have, they are MPP activists, or they belong to political parties. Their reps always go to what? IPAC, and that's where we table everything. Okay, so if MPP have in mind, look, MPP is not the only political party you have in Ghana. They might decide to boycott. And they have already set that record some time ago. They are good at boycotting elections. I think when they even boycott, it will even empower Dr. Park Osinbajo to even challenge President Mahama to even to some percentage. They can decide to boycott. Nobody cares about them because already their house is not in order. So they are looking for excuses.
That's your wish.
No, but your house is not in order.
Thank you. Me?
Yeah.
Are you getting the... drink. Because I am sitting here and listening to both of them, I don't really see any difference in what they are saying. What do you see?
You see, William, thank you very much. I think we all agree that there are problems with the register from the submissions of Mr. Nuchu and Hobson.
Mr. Nuchu. Yes.
And Hobson. And for many other NDC and MPP persons who have spoken, and from the PPP's point of view, we all agree that there are problems with the register. The problem or the bone of contention now is how do we cure that problem, okay? The MPP has come up with its solutions, which we do not think are the best. The NDC is also proposing something else, which we also do not think is the best. But the whole, if you listen to the two political parties, okay, they are all fighting to maintain a certain status quo that will benefit them in some way. And so that's the hula-baloo about whether there should be validation or no validation.
Which I still can't process.
I'm just about to explain it very well, okay. Now, you see, there are problems with the register, like I said. What are some of the problems? That there are minors in the register, people who are below the age of 18, that there are foreigners in the register, Nigerians, Togolese, Ivorians, they are in the register. That there are people who have registered twice, okay? And so the question you would ask yourself is, for these three major problems with the register that we have identified, how do we solve each one of them, okay? The PPP came up with a solution soon after the 2012 elections, but the EC was adamant to it. The media was not willing to discuss it.
What solution was that?
The solutions are that, let me just discuss the problems one by one, and then I tell you the solutions.
Okay.
Number one, that there are foreigners in the register. Mm-hmm. Why would any foreigner want to come and register to get a voter register? Voter ID card. Okay. They would only do that if they have been, invited by a political party to come and do it to help them in a particular constituency. Okay.
My understanding is that Ghanaians in the US and the UK can also vote when they want.
That is RUPAR. That's a different thing altogether. We are not talking about Ghanaians who are living outside.
No.
We are talking about foreigners.
I'm talking about Ghanaians mm-hmm. living in England
mm-hmm.
who are foreigners
mm-hmm.
who are also eligible to vote.
They've applied
their
citizenship.
In that case, they have become citizens
yeah.
over there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, in Ghana here, when you come to Ghana, there is something called the National Identification Authority. The National Identification Authority Act empowered the NIA to determine who is a Ghanaian and who is not a Ghanaian. So the best person to decide whether William Dopo is a Ghanaian or not is the NIA. It is not the EC. Okay? And so both the NDC and MPP, the solutions they are bringing, they are just bringing problems around the neck of the EC, because it is not the duty of the EC to determine who is a Ghanaian or not a Ghanaian. Okay? So what we have been saying is that all these problems about whether there are foreigners in the register or not, they would have come to an end if government, instead of giving the EC money to go and buy new biometric machines, gave that money to the NIA to finish its work.
Okay.
Okay? Because you see, remember in 2012, during the registration, somebody like Neil Antevandapoy, he organized people to Ododododio to go and say that anyone who is not from Ododododio do not allow him to register. And it was bloody. You remember? Okay. The only reason why Neil Ante would do that is that there's a registration which is directly linked to election. Okay. So when you use the NIA, we remove even the fight and the tension, because the person just works to register as a Ghanaian or as a foreigner to be on the NIA. When it is time for election, it is computer. All what you tell the computer is that, please give us all Ghanaians who are above 18 years. So there's no fight about whether you should go and register or not. Okay? That one solves the problem of the foreigners being on the register. Okay? Now, what are the other problems? The other problems are that there are minors on it. Now, the only reason why a 12-year-old boy would want to go and register to get voter ID card is to make political point for somebody. Now, if that boy, if we had empowered the NIA, said that by the time the boy was born, he was registered in the hospital, he can't go back and say, I'm coming to do a new registration, because he was given a national ID number on the day he was born. Eh? So when his card is even missing and he goes back to NIA, they just take his thumbprint and they'll print a new card for him. They will not change his date of birth. So if you want the voter register and you tell the computer to produce all those who are about 18 years, that boy's name will never come in.
I hear you clearly. Clearly,
there were three problems. If I could discuss the last one,
we are running out of time. I like to take your view on what we can do to present a credible register on November 7th. So you have just about 30 seconds.
Okay, let me just do that. You see,
yes,
what we can do now is to, if we want to preserve our peace, then we should just agree with what the EC is proposing to do for us to have our peace. Because you see, either of the solutions that has been preferred will not solve it. If you say validation, so everybody must go again to go and bring his old voter ID card to come and present, it is the same old people who will just come, including the non-Ghanaians, who will come and present it and get validated, and then we'll have them in the register again. Okay, what about those who may have traveled? What about those who may be sick at the time the validation is going on? Are you going to disenfranchise them?
Okay.
No. Okay. On the other side, if you say you want to allow the EC to work with that same register too, we know that it is fraught with so many ills. So at the end of the day, we are going to go into an election that will come out with doubts. Okay. If we want to have a peaceful election, then we just have to agree that in spite of all the problems with the register, we want to work with what the EC has proposed, and then we are going to accept the result. That's all.
in 5 seconds, how do you feel about what appears to be a rejection of your solution of using the NIA to resolve all these problems by the EC? What are you going to do?
We have done a lot. We have petitioned the EC, we have petitioned the president, we have held several press conferences on this matter, but it just appears.
But you haven't been to the court.
Well, you see, you cannot compel a constitutionally set up independent body to do something that it does not intend to do by an order of a court. Okay? You can only do that through public pressure. Okay? Because even the courts themselves, if you study jurisprudence, you would realize that the courts themselves respond to the views of the people that happen. They take judicial notice of the things that happen around them. And so we expect the EC.
And the courts also take decisions based on public interest.
Yes, but the court in this case cannot direct the EC to do this one. You would have to give specific orders to the EC. And that will amount to compromising the independence of the EC. And so the courts cannot ask the EC.
Willie, a very quick one. You see, what Hussein is saying, Hussein and his groups are saying that there was a recommendation. You see, you can recommend. The EC might decide to take it or not.
Do you know something?
Yes.
In the 1992 Constitution.
Yeah, 30 seconds, because we have two more topics to deal with.
No problem. Article 54. I just want to go. He said administrative expenses of the Electoral Commission, including salaries, allowances, and pensions, payable to or in respect of persons serving with the commission, shall be charged on the consolidated fund. Yes. What does it mean? Are they not public officials? Okay. So what are you saying? What are you saying that we cannot touch them? Okay. And I disagree that we should go by what EC is proposing.
Of course.
It's not true. We cannot. So if EC is saying that, look, Papa Kwesi Indum, we'll make sure we will not register him, we should go by that. We will not.
Okay.
We will not.
Yeah.
So what we want to say is that, what we want to say is that the national identification, who instituted that program, when we were trying to bring that issue up, Papa Kwesi Indum was part of the whole setup. Are you getting it? These people, they were fighting against. They were telling the people.
Anytime you say these people here.
These people, NDC.
Okay.
NDC. You know, it was, we were preparing it that, look, this doubt about whatever age and all that, Ghanaian, non-Ghanaian, because on the card, it will be stated clearly that you are a Ghanaian or non-Ghanaian. I have witnessed elections in Belgium. I have witnessed it in their parliamentary in Germany. Look, you will not even know that there's elections going on. They can call anyone at all. You may not even know who you are being agent for. You just go and stand there. They finish and then they take the thing. They declare the results. You will not hear anything. Just like that. Because you cannot change your date of birth.
No.
When you are due, you qualify to vote, they will write to you. You will not even go. They will write to you. When it's about 2 weeks, when it's about 2 weeks or 1 month to elections, they will write to you that election day, so and so, you need to go. If you don't go and vote, they can charge you. Are you getting it?
Yeah.
So if we put this system in place, why should a foreigner come and then vote?
Okay.
Yeah.
Point well.
Yeah, Willie.
30 seconds.
Yeah, Willie. You see, what he's referring to in page 20 and page 21, that does not exist. I recommend
it. Have you checked it?
No, I'm trying to check. I told my battery is down that one. But I read it.
So you don't see that's not easy.
It is a recommendation and not bind on the commission.
Okay.
You understand me?
Okay.
Now, we are talking about young ones having their names in the register.
Yes, minors.
And minors and foreigners. So it's Adoye sitting here insulting the intelligence of the MPP agent that day. That sacrificed their life and time to protect their interests. That they were blind.
What is the meaning?
No, the meaning is that because if no
doctor, will,
oh please, I can't,
you don't do that propaganda on me.
No, please. So at the end of the day, if you see, I like the recent comment of our founder, Fly Left Nigeria Journalist, His Excellency, that the word is what? Vigilance. You go, look, Willie, I have participated in electoral process from 1992 to date. You see, the MPP guys are so lazy to the standard. Even when you go to the printing house, I'm telling you something, when you are supposed to be so vigilant, you see them just chatting. The same thing applied to them on the day of voting. Because they are pulling agents. No, I'm just a minute. They are pulling agents.
We have
don't
records.
Even have records of whatever.
We have president. Records
okay, that's your
shown by no, it's a fact. Commission.
Let me tell you
that we have 8 years, 9 years registering.
You are right. The, Dr.